Hey guys, I'm Scythian, and today we're going over how to buy DPR. Now, I'm Canadian, so my starting step will be a bit different for other countries, but the rest of the steps will be the same. By the end of this video, you will know how to buy DPR, and if you were planning on staking, you'll be prepared for that too. So, let's dive into it. So, step one is to turn our fiat, aka cash, into crypto. I start on Nuden, a Canadian app, but some of you may start on Coinbase, Binance, Crypto.com, CEX, and so on. It is also possible to just buy directly on MetaMask in some countries if your country allows credit card purchases for crypto. If this is the route you want to take, you can go ahead and jump to the timestamp in the description down below and see how to buy on MetaMask. But I don't recommend that route, as the gas fees are unpredictable. If you're super new to crypto, gas fees are just transaction costs on the various crypto networks, and on Ethereum-based networks like UniSwap, which is the MetaMask method, gas fees fluctuate based on congestion of the network at the time of your transaction. Now, I know in the US you guys typically have waiting times once you deposit money, such as 5, 7, or even 10-day holding periods. I've been told by some US friends that if you use a direct debit card purchase on Coinbase, you can avoid this hold for a fee. It's not cheap though, they paid $80 or so to instantly clear a few grand. But if you are in a time pinch, this is an option for you. I've also been told that for US customers new to crypto.com, the first 30 days of transaction fees for debit cards are waived, which is even better than those expensive Coinbase fees. So, getting back to step one, I will deposit cash into my initial exchange. From here, I'm going to buy USDT, as this is what I'll need for the DPR exchange process. Now, my exchange covers $5 in withdrawal fees, but not many do this. Actually, I've never heard of any except for this one. If the exchange you deal with charges too much to move USDT, because on most exchanges it's done solely through the Ethereum network, then I recommend buying XLM, as it is an insanely cheap option to transfer between exchanges. If your exchange allows you to send USDT over the Tron network, then that is also pretty cheap to do. Sadly, none in my region provide this. Anyhow, for the simplicity of this tutorial, we're going to stick with USDT. Our next step is to set up our account on MEXC and obtain the deposit address to send our USDT to. The reason we don't buy directly on MEXC is because MEXC is blocked in many countries from direct purchase and requires KYC to be able to fund fiat straight to their site. KYC is Know Your Customer for the new people here, where you must show your ID to verify your identity and location. The basic MEXC account does not require KYC to do trades or withdrawals up to 0.7 Bitcoin a day, which is thousands of dollars in withdrawal limit, so no worries unless you are a huge investor, at which point it will take multiple days to withdraw all your money. So, with a basic account, we can deposit our USDT, trade it for DPR, and withdraw it to MetaMask or any other hot wallet, which I will go over at a later step. You will also need to have an authentication method turned on to be able to withdraw from MEXC, such as text codes or Google Authenticator. To obtain that direct deposit address, click Assets, Account, Deposit, select USDT, ERC20 for the Ethereum network, if that's the one you're using on your initial exchange, and confirm to obtain your deposit address. Go ahead and copy this. Do not try to type it out. That is a huge mistake waiting to happen. Step 3. Send our USDT from our initially funded exchange to our MEXC account. Head to the withdrawal section and enter your MEXC deposit address and select all the USDT you want to send to it. If you're worried about sending it to the wrong address, a great tip is to send a small amount first to ensure you've copied everything correctly. Yes, you'll pay an extra transaction fee, but that's a lot better than sending all your money to the wrong place, losing it forever. It's happened to many people, and it's happened to people I know personally. Step 4. Once our USDT has arrived, click Market and search for DPR in the search bar. Here we can see the seller's prices and quantities, and can set how much we want to buy at what price. You can set the price higher, and it will just buy from the cheapest sellers. If your goal was to only own DPR, congratulations, you are now the proud owner of DPR tokens. If you're here to find out how to stake those tokens for a free Genesis miner, starting at a minimum of 20,000 DPR up to 468,000, then once we have our desired amount of DPR, we can move on to step 5, creating a MetaMask account. If you already have one, or any other hot wallet that accepts ERC20 and have added the DPR token to the coin list, go ahead and skip to step 6. So, step 5. Head to metamask.io and click download now. Click create a wallet and follow the steps. Make sure to write down your secret backup phrase. This mnemonic phrase is the key to your wallet. Guard it with your life. After we're done creating our MetaMask account, which, by the way, I recommend MetaMask over any other hot wallet for this process, as the staking platform only accepts MetaMask and Wallet Connect. Any other hot wallet will have to link to Wallet Connect to proceed, which is just extra steps that we can avoid. I also want to remind everyone, never share the private key or seed phrase / mnemonic phrase of your account. This is how scammers will steal all your money. I also recommend a ledger linked to your MetaMask account, so that if someone does hack it, they can't withdraw anything without your ledger's physical button-clicked approval. Also, always lock your MetaMask account before browsing the internet if you are on a PC, as the entire browser is open to your wallet. So before you go to any other websites, you're going to want to lock that down. We need to add the coin to our coin list so that we can see our held amount. You will click Add Token, Custom Token, and enter the contract address, which I will provide in the description down below, as well as a link to verify that contract address so that you guys know you are entering the accurate one. From here, we can copy our wallet deposit address at the top. This address is the same for all ERC20 based coins. So with that, we are ready to move to the next step. Step 6. Head back to Assets, Account, and this time click Withdrawal. Search DPR, and we will be ready to enter the deposit address from our MetaMask account. Again, if you are worried about sending it to the wrong address, send a small amount first to ensure you've copied everything correctly. Also note there is a fee of 185 DPR at this time, so ensure you have some extra DPR to make the transfer. Once your tokens show up in MetaMask, we will be ready to continue to the staking process. And as promised, for those who just want to buy through MetaMask, you can purchase ETH directly on MetaMask, should your credit card allow this. Click Buy, and then click Continue to Wire. Once you have your Ethereum, then you can head over to uniswap.org, launch the app, connect your wallet, and under Select a Token, enter the contract address from the description down below, and switch your ETH for your desired amount of DPR. You can also switch other crypto to DPR through here, if you have anything else you wish to trade. So now that we have our DPR in our MetaMask account, we can go ahead and sign up for whitelisting and staking. Head to the DPR website, which I have linked to my referral link down below. If you don't want to use my referral link, go ahead and delete the referral ending to that URL. I won't be offended, but using it does help the channel. Sign up and provide all your info for shipping, what tier you're staking at, create a DPR wallet for future rewards on your miner. Be sure to both download the private key and write down the seed phrase just in case. And head to the staking page. Here we will link our MetaMask account, accept the contract, and then accept the staking. You will need ETH to pay the contract and staking gas fees. So go ahead and send some Ethereum to your MetaMask account from your initial exchange where you bought the USDT. I recommend $50 to $100 worth to be safe. Me personally, I only had to spend $4 to approve the contract and about $18 to approve the staking. If it doesn't load between the contract and staking, just refresh the page and re-click staking. I also have a video showing how to adjust our gas fee higher to ensure our transaction doesn't get rejected by the network, which is quite common on Ethereum. If you get essentially outbid on gas prices, the network picks the highest prices first. So if you bid too low, then you're going to get bumped down on the list and it'll take a lot longer. Or sometimes if you don't have the limit set high enough, the transaction just expires and it takes your gas fee money. So once you've completed all that, you're staked. And if selected, ready to obtain that miner. Once they are ready to go, they will be shipped to the info you provided at signup. If you enjoyed the video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Also, feel free to join us on Telegram and Discord if you have any additional questions or just want to join the great community. Links in the description down below. Thanks for watching, keep your data safe, and I'll see you in the next video.